मुल्क शाम का अजीम बादशाह इब्राहिम मदम एक रात अपने आलीशान महल के एक पुरसैश कमरे के नरम बिस्तर पर खुदा की याद में मशगूल था। उसे लोगों की खिदमत करने का, लोगों के लिए नेकी के काम करने का, उनके लिए सहूलतें और आसानियां पैदा करने का बहुत शौक था। और इसी स्नान में उसने अपने महल की छत के ऊपर चंद कदमों की आवाज़ सुनी। बड़ा हैरान हुआ और नीचे से आवाज़ लगा के कहा कि छत के ऊपर कौन है? तो आवाज़ आई कि मैं एक साथ वाले शहर का भटका हुआ मुसाफिर हूँ, मेरे ऊंट रास्ता खो गए हैं और उनको ढूंढता मैं महल की छत पर पहुँच गया हूँ। इब्राहिम बिन आदम बड़ा गुस्से हुआ और कहा कि बेवकूफ़ शख्स, क्या कभी महल की छतों पर भी ऊँट मिले हैं? तो उस शख्स ने जवाब दिया, इब्राहिम बिन आदम, अगर महल की छतों पर ऊँट नहीं मिल सकते तो इन आलीशान महलों के पुरसैश कमरों के नरम बिस्तर पे खुदा का मिलना भी नामुमकिन सी बात है। ये बात सुनते ही इब्राहिम रदम पर एक लर्जा सा तारी हो गया और अगली सुबह अपने अपनी बादशाहत, अपनी पुरसैश ज़िंदगी, अपने आलीशान महल सारा कुछ छोड़ के जंगल का रास्ता किया और बाकी की सारी ज़िंदगी छोटी सी झोंपड़ियों, जंगलों और रास्तों में गुजारी। और खल्के खुदा की खिदमत, उनके लिए आसानियाँ पैदा करना और उनकी खिदमत के लिए और उनकी सर्विस में गुजार दी। उसकी नीयत थी और उसकी नीयत को उसने अपने एक्शन में बदला और उसके इस एक्शन की वजह से दुनिया इब्राहिम बिन आदम को एक अजीम शख्स के नाम पर आज भी जानती है। माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, एवरीबॉडी इन दिस वर्ल्ड हैज़ गुड इंटेंशंस बट नॉट एवरीबॉडी लिव्स इंटेंशनली। द ग्रेटेस्ट गैप दीज डेज इन आवर लाइफ इज बिटवीन नोइंग थिंग्स एंड डूइंग थिंग्स। नो वन इन दिस वर्ल्ड विल बी सक्सेसफुल जस्ट बिकॉज ही और शी हैज़ गुड इंटेंशंस, but a lot of people will be successful with their good actions, and that is what we call living an intentional and purposeful life. How to live an intentional life? When you live an intentional life, you ensure that the time you have, the day you have, the people you have, and the opportunities you have, you are going to utilize the best of your abilities and capabilities to pursue your goals and to achieve your dreams. Because when you are living intentionally, you always play on the front foot. And when you're living an unintentional life, you get up early in the morning, you go to college, you go to university, you go to office, and something surprises you and you say, oh my God, what happened with me? And that's how life treats you when you treat life unpurposeful. Let me tell you one thing, nothing is automatic in life. The only thing automatically happens after your birth and my birth is that we die automatically. We don't have to work on it. We don't have to go to any class or any university to learn how we should die. So your success must be intentional. 95% of people living in this world have very good intentions. And their intentions say, one day I will get rich and I will have my dream house. One day I will get rich and I will open up the biggest charity organization in the world. One day, I will be the most successful actor in my life. They people have good intentions, but they are not intentional because they don't take strong actions every single day to reach where they want to reach. So the thing is, when you live intentionally, you don't accept life. You make life. You take the responsibility who you are, what you are, and where you have to reach. Let me share with you one very simple ritual that I exercise to get intentional in my life. I decided to stay away from virtual world, from internet for 48 hours last week, and I did it. It was very much difficult for me because I never exercised for the last 10 years, but I did it. But most important thing that I learned 5 very important lessons in those 48 hours. Number one. The ability to control your mind is the highest level of human attribute that you can learn, because when you start controlling your mind, you start controlling your life. Number two, you reflect and you improve your focus on what is important for your life, what is important for you in your life, and you start planning how you have to reach there. Number three, having access to everything in life, practicing your mind to stay away from such things is another level of human grace. And that's where you divert your mind from autopilot to a self-controlled mood and you start living the life you really want to live. Number four, you build a very strong emotional connection with the people around, the friends, your family, the society, and the most beautiful nature Allah has created for us. Last but not the least, you really come to know how much this world damn care about you. having more than 5,000 friends on Facebook, 2,000 followers on Twitter, 1,200 followers on Instagram, Snapchat, LinkedIn, and all other social networks. Only two people in those 48 hours bothered to call me and said, Malik, are you okay? We haven't seen you since yesterday on internet. क्या आप भी ये देखना चाहते हैं कि who really matters in your life? और आपका जो वक्त है, आपको किसे देना चाहिए? Practice this ritual. So my friends, there are two things in life. One is to know your purpose, and then it is to rise above your purpose and to go and to help others. And the second thing is very important. John Maxwell has written a book, the best story I have ever read. When you open up this book, the whole book is empty. There is only one page which is written with something. And there is one line written on that page, and that line is, everything you have read so far is other people's stories. This is the moment, this is the time you should start writing your own story with your own hands and start living an intentional life. My dear friends, your life is your story and you are the central character of your story. You choose its title, you choose its theme. So why not to write a story which truly matters? Not to write the bestseller.